You finished your Christmas shopping?
I just went the other day.
Where did you finish it?
Marks and Spencer's.
Oh, posh.
Where did you go?
Poundland. Oh, got everything all sorted.
For a pound?
Everything's a pound.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
2 weeks off at Christmas and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
How the Grinch Stole Christmas.
And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling, how could it be so?
It came without ribbons, it came without tags, it came without packages, boxes or bags.
And he puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. What if Christmas, he thought, didn't come from a store?
What if Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more?
On the third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Thank you.
birthday of Christmas my true love sent to me.
Four calling birds, three French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
The birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary.
The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured. The Lord is with you."
Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end."
Day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
6 geese a-laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Hope is the thing with feathers, by Emily Dickinson. Hope is the thing with feathers that perches in the soul and sings the tune without the words and never stops at all. And sweetest in the gale is heard, and sore must be the storm that could abash the little bird that kept so many warm. I've heard it in this chillest land and on the strangest sea, yet never in extremity it asked a crumb of me.
Welcome everybody. Here we have the house competition results as part of our Christmas celebrations. And we're doing things slightly differently this year in that we have a termly series of results We'll go through a few of the highlights that we've had this so far this year, involving sport and academic activities.
We've run a wide range of competitions so far this year, so thank you to everyone that's entered. We've had some brilliant entries and some wonderful creative pieces of work. We are going to run through a presentation now of the awards of who has won which competition, and tutors will be giving out certificates to celebrate this within your form.
Moving on to the house competition results, we've decided to categorise them into three groups. So we have the school competitions, the subject-based competitions, and then the sports competitions.
We started with the notice board competition, where every tutor group designs their own notice board to support their house identity with their logo and name on it. So well done to those people that participated in that.
Here we have the school's pumpkin carving competition, which was a really good competition we had. And here you can see some of our entries.
Remember to go single-use plastic free. Moving on to Movember, we had loads of great events running throughout the whole of Movember. So well done to Mr. Gaffin and for everyone else that organised those. Here you can see an excellent cake that was our winning cake for that competition.
You all enjoyed the house basketball shootout competition. Year 10's had theirs this week and really enjoyed that. And we'll be doing similar competitions like this after Christmas.
And well done to those that participated in the subject competitions. We've had a few of these running this term, and there's going to be a whole load of them running next term as well. Well done, especially for the poetry competition. And the winning poem will be read out by Dr. Kent at the end of this.
And now on to the house competition results. So as well as the array of competitions we've had throughout this term, we've also appointed house captains, which is a new role. And we've got the students you can see on the board from each year group that are helping to organise the competitions and doing a lot of work in terms of leadership within each house. So I'd like to say welcome and thank you to all of the students that have taken the role as house captain. And they'll be continuing that in the new term. Here we've got some lovely photographs of our house captains, so you can know who their familiar faces are.
One of the most exciting competitions for me personally was the Kent logo competition. We had loads of really great entries with loads of really different designs, but George in 7 Kent was the overall winner, so well done, George.
The next competitions coming up are listed here. Loads of exciting opportunities to get involved, and your house captains and your form tutors will be really trying to push your involvement. The more we get involved, the better.
Congratulations everybody. Merry Christmas.
All I Want for Christmas by Louis and Bartosz in 7K. It's Christmas Day, a time to play. I jump for joy with my new toy. I smile, I laugh, with a present perhaps, though one catches my eye. It has to be mine. It's big, it's tall, it can't be a ball. It's wide and flat, it can't be a bat. I rip it open, wild-eyed. There's a flat-screen TV inside.
And here we have a poem from Daniel Pink's In Nine Mina. Children crunch through the turgid snow. Birds sing as they grace through the frozen air. Adults dart in and out of bustling shops, hoping to find presents for distant relatives. But times have changed. Lives have been spent indoors as the world locks down, hidden away from reality in the newfound bubbles, which bind us together yet further apart. Through all of this, however, nature goes on. The birds still sing, cattle still graze, plants still bear the winter bloom. This year may be different, but we can still make it special. Take time to appreciate the details of life and make this Christmas one to remember.
This is a poem about the 12 days of lockdown that was a joint composition by 9S. On the 12th day of lockdown, my true love gave to me 12 nurses nursing, 11 neighbours clapping, 10 grandparents zooming, 9 parents homeschooling, 8 pupils isolating, 7 shoppers bulk buying, 6 family members from one household meeting, 5 toilet rolls, 4 washable masks, 3 hand sanitizers, 2 meters distance, and a coronavirus vaccine for me.
On the 7th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
7 senior leaders, 6 geese are laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent. Senior leaders, 6 geese are laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Live in joy, in love, even among those who hate. Live in joy, in health, even among the afflicted. Live in joy, in peace, even among the troubled. Look within, be still, free from fear and attachment. Know the sweet joy of living in the way. There is no fire like greed, no crime like hatred, no sorrow like separation, no sickness like hunger of heart, and no joy like the joy of freedom. Health, contentment, and trust are your greatest possessions, and freedom your greatest joy. Look within, be still, free from fear and attachment, know the sweet joy of living in the way.
Why was the snowman looking through the carrots? He was picking his nose.
Hey, hilarious.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Mary.
Mary who?
Merry Christmas.
Ready? Go.
Yeah. They didn't even pull.
Where do snowmen go to dance?
I don't know. Where do they go to dance?
Snowballs.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
9 ladies dancing, 8 maids a milking, 7 senior leaders, 6 geese a laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Thank you.
On the 10th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
10 Movember Mobros, 9 ladies dancing, 8 maids a milking, 7 senior leaders, 6 geese a laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
Go.
Oh, unlucky. Knock, knock. Who's there? Mary. Oh, wait, I've messed it up there. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Mary.
Mary who?
Merry Christmas.
What do snowmen eat for lunch?
What?
Ice burgers.
Oh, no. Right, what happens to elves that are naughty?
What?
Santa gives them the sack.
the 11th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
11 pipers piping, 10 Movember Mobros, 9 ladies dancing, 8 maids a-milking, 7 senior leaders, 6 geese a-laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
But when the kindness and love of God our Saviour appeared, he saved us not because of the righteous things that we had done, but because of his mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Saviour, so that, having been justified by his grace, we might become heirs, having the hope of eternal life.
Christmas, my true love sent to me 12 head prefects, 11 pipers piping, 10 Movember Mobros, 9 ladies dancing, 8 maids a milking, 7 senior leaders, 6 geese a laying, 5 sheriff houses, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 weeks off at Christmas, and a head teacher called Dr. Kent.
I think we finished that one.
I'm
3 short thank yous from me. First of all, a huge thank you to Mr. Watson Tate, to Mr. Kelsey, and all those who've come together to make this virtual carol concert possible. I think it's been a tremendous celebration, both of the spirit of Christmas and also of the spirit of the school, which, despite the fact that we haven't been able to hold a face-to-face event, has still been a wonderful opportunity for us to come together, in sometimes in a virtual way, to celebrate everything that Christmas and indeed Lawrence Sheriff is about. A second thank you actually goes to all of you, because this term obviously has been challenging at times because of all we've had to deal with relating to COVID-19. I think everyone in the Lawrence Sheriff community, staff and students and parents, have worked together to make this a tremendously successful term. When we've achieved a huge amount, despite all of the issues we've had to contend with and overcome, we've come together, we've worked together, and I think we can look back with justifiable pride on all that we've done, all that we've achieved during this term. And a huge thank you to everybody from me. And a final and really, really important thank you goes from me on behalf of everybody involved in any way with Lawrence Sheriff, to Mr. Shaw, who retires today after 100 terms at Lawrence Sheriff School. I think I can say on behalf of all of us that Martin Shaw embodies everything that is best about Lawrence Sheriff. Martin, we owe you a huge debt of gratitude for everything that you've given to the school, both within the classroom as a teacher, but also in so many different ways to the whole life, the whole set of values that make up the school. Thank you so much. And it has been a fantastic experience to have been able to work with Mr. Shaw, and we wish him a very, very happy retirement. And of course, if this was a face-to-face event, at this point, I would pause so we could all give a huge round of applause to Mr. Shaw. So I'm going to pause anyway. Mr. Shaw, thank you. And thank you to all of you. And I hope you have a well-earned break over the coming holiday.